camera. This is my first video doing with new camera, so I hope it will go well. Welcome back to my channel, guys. Today it's a beautiful cloudy day, of course the rainy season of Miami, so I decide that it's a good time to review my two most worn bags of the season, which are of course these. I am not going to lie, I was not expecting that to happen. So, you know, Chanel, that's my everyday bag to go. But when I got this bag for Christmas, I was so obsessed with it. Like, literally obsessed. Every time I can wear this bag, guys, I will. And few weeks ago, I just decided and went for the smaller size in black. So, now I have a little friends. I have been asked to make a video about these two, to compare them to each other. As you can see, the size difference is kind of big. So I want to share with you, first of all, my points, what I think may be the good part of this bag and what is not that good part of this bag. So as you all know, wearing this bag this way is super ladylike, it's beautiful, it's super elegant. But as well, if you stuff it too heavy, that maybe won't be so comfortable, so you cannot do this with this bag. Is it everyday bag? Definitely not. It's a bag which should make you feel special, which the kind of bag you will wear when you just, like, you know, don't need to carry documents. So definitely not everyday bag. So guys, I know you're probably going to be questioning why I decided for this leather. I think they call it the intrecciato, is it correct? The woven leather, in my kind of way to say. So I decided for this one because I feel, you know, even I personally don't like as many labels on myself. Like, I don't like to wear, you know, things which scream Chanel, Dior. I mean, I like the bags, of course, and the shoes and the clothes, but I don't like too much label. And what I appreciate about Bottega Veneta, that it doesn't do it, but the leather tells you this is Bottega. Very, like, you know, very elegant way, and I really appreciate that. That's what I really like. I actually took my time before I decided to go for these bags. I know they were very popular a while ago. Like 2 years ago, people were like obsessed with them, and I think now it stopped a little bit, and that's the time for me to buy when not everybody is wearing it. And that's what I always kind of do. So I decided to buy two. This one I got for Christmas, as you know. So this is, as you can see, I have a paper inside when, you know, it's sitting in the closet, so it doesn't like sit on empty and it doesn't get super flat. Even so, the reason I decided for this leather is not just because I love how elegant it looks and how beautifully it represents the brand. Ugh, the brand. I already had coffee, so I don't know what's going on. The brand. I just feel like it's more structured than the other leather. That's my opinion, what I've seen. So yeah, look inside. Inside you have the same leather. Here you have the gorgeous logo imprinted to the leather. Right there, you have a little hook here which you can clip, I guess, things to, but I don't see a point of that. I don't know why is that there. So this bag fits literally everything. This bag will fit everything you need for every single day. Like, every time you will go somewhere, you can like fit many things in it, and it's elegant. And you see the shape here, it's like stays, and that's what I like of it. This is like the very old school classic shape of bags, like back in the days when the ladies were wearing bags of this size, in this shape. I think even Chanel actually did something, let me move the papers away. Even Chanel did something in that style long time ago. So I know this is definitely a classic piece. And I decided for two favorite colors of mine, which is like this caramel brown, beige tone, and black, of course. And actually, guys, I am considering to go for the larger bag in the black as well, because, you know, that's my favorite color. I love everything in black. So yes, So this bag, let me show you what will fit you inside of these two bags. So what I like to do, because Miami, we live on air conditioning. So when you go to a restaurant, you wear summer dress because it's hot outside, but inside it gets cold. So what I do, I always take a scarf, which I fold two small pieces. This is like cotton silk scarf from Fendi, super old guys. I have this for like a century. How old am I? Anyway, so I like to put the scarf to the back on the bottom or sideways because it fits. You see that? So you literally can fit everything. Where's my phone? Your phone. Hand sanitizer wipes, tissues, your mirror, all the makeup you need, refreshing your face, blush, lipstick, concealer, and lip balm. So this you technically all can put there, and you can even have like a little cosmetic bag in it. I will not go for something too heavy or structured because that could be uncomfortable to wear under your shoulder. Now it's getting a little bit heavy already, but it's okay, I still can do this. Such a beautiful, elegant and chic bag, like it will make, you know, you. And what I like about this style is you can wear it with jeans and t-shirt, with evening dress. It just makes, like, you know, the person, the little touch, so you don't look like you're trying too hard, but you're still very elegant at the same time. And even like I say, just jeans and t-shirt will be turned with this bag into such a beautiful feminine outfit, and I like that. I am personally more sporty in my outfits, so I appreciate details like that. So now this little beauty, the same kind of leather, the woven leather. This one has the strap, which you can tie it up here and make it a little bit shorter or longer, whatever you wish for. I actually need to figure out, there is a way how you can tie this like this and it looks elegant. I just didn't figure out how yet, but I'm getting idea right now as we speak. I think I am. Anyway, so the same thing on inside with much less space. So the good thing is it fits your cell phone, but guys, it's tight, very tight. The next thing what it fits will be your car case. You put it to the different side of the pouch. And then I would say lipstick and lip balm. Those are my two things to go with me everywhere. And that's about it, guys. Yeah, that's about it. You cannot put much more to it unless you like wearing coat and you can put your cell phone to your pocket in your coat. Cell phone technically takes over the bag. And yes, of course it gets heavy, I mean, but it's okay, all of our bag gets heavy. Dior, Chanel, Hermes, those bags are super heavy, so that's okay. Anyway, as you can see, it doesn't really fit much, guys, but I have to say this bag just became like the bag I wear everywhere I can. Even over the bigger one. I appreciate this one so much, so much, so much. But this one is the new baby, so I wear it more often right now. So yes, but the only problem, when I go out, I really can just take a hairbrush, mini tiny hairbrush. You can put there as well, like sideways. Or if you don't want to take your card case, maybe you'll be better if you just like threw your credit cards there or cash, whatever you like to use. Lipsticks for me are must and cell phone is must. These days camera is must as well. This won't fit camera even if I try. Like, camera is definitely something I just have to keep holding in my hand. Beauty over comfort any day. So yes, this is the small size, guys. You see, it doesn't really fit much. The size is very different. What I really appreciate is you can wear it crossbody. I just love that. I like to do, as I say, my style is more sporty. So even if I wear like, you know, something more elegant, why not to do that? It just looks so cute. I will recommend you to make the strap shorter so it holds like up, more up. Don't have it like slouching too low, because that doesn't look correct. In my personal opinion, I think it's much nicer if you have it a little bit higher, like in your waistline. That's like the ideal, you know, length for the strap for me, honestly. So I just, what I did before, I just technically tied up the leather like this, and I had it hanging like sideways. But I seen on Instagram the way the people tied up here. They just do like, I think I have to unknot this part, and I will just tie it up like the knot. But I don't know how I'm gonna do it on the other side. Need to study that part. I wish some Bottega Veneta employee did tutorial on that. I have friends who work there, so maybe I should ask if they know. Anyway, guys, these are the two sizes of the most worn bags for me of this season, this year. What I really appreciate is that you don't see them as much around as you see, let's say, Chanel, Hermes or Dior. You do see them, but not as much. And I like that very much. I like the quality of the leather. I like the sound of the leather. I like how it feels. These two bags definitely stole my heart. I wasn't expecting it. First, I was very, I don't want it. I don't want the pouch. I think it's unpractical. But guys, when we ladies are practical with our fashion pieces, like when we practical, like hello, never, thank you. So yes, that's the comparison. Really, this bag fits literally everything. The only problem of this is that you have to carry it in your hand or under your shoulder. So if it's too bulky, if you have too much stuff, it can get uncomfortable. If you carry things in it this way, holding down, it will be too heavy. So I will not overstuff even any of these bags. Like, this fits more, but don't overstuff it as well. Don't forget, this kind of leather imprints denim. So if you wear it down on your denim, the denim can imprint to the leather. You don't want to ruin this beauty with color, you know, transfer from your outfit. So be careful with that. Carry it a little bit higher up. Don't slash it like over your denim. I know very popular is as well buying these bags in white. So very careful with that. Keep the summer outfits lighter. So yes, guys. So these are the two bags which stole my heart of 2021. I actually even put my Dior aside. My Lady Dior, my Dior saddlebag. My Chanel bag is my everyday bag, so I do wear that quite often, but everything else is just like sitting in the closet right now. And of course, I will continue wearing those bags. I have them, it's called classic collection, but these two are at the moment, actually for the last 6 months, for me, must go for bags. Every time I'm buying something, I'm imagining how these bags will look with that outfit. So as you can see, the leather is like shiny, but not too dramatically. I have, of course, light on here, so it shows you the detail, how perfectly beautiful this bag is. The only problem is it really fits four things. So if you are considering purchasing these bags, you have to count on it that your life must be a little bit lighter. You cannot carry many things. So yes, let me show you one more time inside. Inside is beautiful leather as well. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. If you are considering buying the bag, I highly recommend you to do it. The price range is not that bad as well for them. I think it's actually like from luxury Italian brand. I think this one is $1,750 in the US dollar. And this one, let me see, I have the price here actually, because I don't remember, because I didn't buy it. This one is $3,200, and it is something you should keep in your closet forever, because you can wear this in any age, guys. You can be 20-year-old, you can be 50-year-old, you can be my age, any age, and you can wear this, unless you have arthritis, whatever. Forget that. I decided for the Impreziato leather in both styles. With this one, the second I saw it online on Instagram, I was absolutely sold on the color, because it's beautiful caramel beige classic color. It fits with everything. Like, you can wear it with white t-shirt, you can wear it with dresses, it's just so beautiful. But I'm planning to go for the large size in black as well, because you know, black is, that's my color, that's my thing. So guys, these are my two most worn bags of the season. I just wanted to share it with you because I love them so much. I think they're so beautiful and elegant, and for me these are definitely pieces to stay. And if ever Bottega decide to discontinue, I will have to, before that happens, I will have to buy this one in black in that large size, and maybe this smaller one in the other leather, which I almost purchased. I almost went for the like the khaki, it's like military style green, which is so beautiful and elegant. But when I almost purchased it, I was just like, yes, this one. But then my husband was like, are you sure about it? Because think of what your closet looks like. And with honestly, it won't fit the color combinations of my closet much. So I actually decided for the black one. And to me, it was much better decision. Even I did love the green. So maybe later, or maybe I go for like summer light color with the other leather. We'll see. It's in the stars what will be my next Bottega purchase. Actually, you know, I'm loving the shoes right now as well. So anyway guys, I just wanted to thank you so much for watching my videos, for commenting, for giving me your thumbs up. Love it. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope I did good with comparing the two sizes, because you asked me to do it and I just like to deliver it what you asked me to do. So I am going to actually get ready to go to work right now, and I'll see you next week. Bye bye.